Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to another video. So for today's tutorial, I'll be teaching you guys the Anaconda. So the Anaconda is just this huge flourish, you probably saw it in the intro. Most likely you've seen it on a lot of people's Instagram. If you haven't, check out my Instagram, link in description. But besides that, I think it's a great move to add to your repertoire. I'd say it's kind of like the Cardists version of the spring, as in it's the one big power move that you see people do a lot. So yeah, great move to learn. It looks super dope on camera, and you know, if you get the right profile, kind of the way the cars come off the back, it really does look a bit like, to me it looks a bit more like a cobra. I don't know about you. Maybe I'm overthinking this. Yeah, I'm overthinking this. Anyways, without further ado, just grab yourselves a deck of cards, preferably a deck where the sides are mostly even, so smoothed out and broken in, but you want the sides mostly even. Grab yourselves a deck of cards. Let's hop right into the tutorial. Alright, so I'm gonna kind of break this up into two sections. The right hand, so kind of like how I did the riffle fan. So the right hand part, which coincidentally is actually the same as the riffle fan. So if you already know that just from the riffle fan, you can probably skip this. I'll try to leave a timestamp also in the description right down there. But yeah, I'll split it up into the right hand, which is just the dribble, and then the whole thing as a whole, like how you want to angle everything so that the flourish comes out right. But starting off with the right hand, so you have a deck of cards, and what you want to do, the goal of it, is to dribble down cards one by one, right, and have them fall evenly and have a slight tilt to them as they fall. So how you're going to get to this is you're going to take these three fingers, right, and you're going to place them on the edge of the deck, just like that. And your index finger is going to be out and your thumb is going to be here. For me, I put my thumb right on this side of the corner, so right about there-ish. I've heard different people say different things. Some people say you want it parallel, some people have it angled like this, but I have mine right here and I kind of bring my thumb in. That's just what works for me, but you can experiment with your thumb and the timing of everything a little bit just to get what works for you. But the overall movement is your three fingers are here, your index is here, your thumb is here, and your thumb is riffling up the back of the deck. Now you will need your fingers a little bit moist to do this. Like if your hands are too dry, your thumb will just slip and it'll create this weird like sporadic thing. It won't feel good, like it'll feel horrible, and it won't sound as good, and it won't be even most of all. So make sure your fingers, you can rub your hands a bit like this, just so you feel a bit of moisture, and that will help you get the cards to drop one by one, just like that. And then these fingers here, as you go up, these three fingers on the outside are slowly going to curl outward, just like that. And your index finger is going to be pressing down, so it's going to be the counter pressure to your thumb. So your thumb pulls up like that, and your index finger is going to push down. Right, so between the two of those, you create this arc in the deck, right? And you want to resist the urge to do this, because at first it feels normal to curl your index finger in just to get more pressure. But if you do this, in the end, you won't be able to get the last few cards off as nicely when you learn the Anaconda. So just start off like this. It might take some practice just to build up the muscle memory. Well, it will take practice to build up the muscle memory, but it might take some time just to build up the muscle. So yeah, so just learn the form, and if you haven't done this before, practice it. It took me a few months, so it will take a bit of time, so you want to get the form right to start off with. So first off, with the three fingers here, the general thing is they're going to hold the deck, right? You're holding the deck like this, but as the deck gets thinner, right, as it gets thinner, these are going to curl out just to make sure they're not holding on to the cards. Because what you want to avoid is if you don't curl out with these, what'll happen is the cards will kind of stick. I'm not sure if you see that, right? So it'll look something like that. And the cards won't fall nicely. So you want to put your fingers just lined up on the edge, just like that. Just so as the card drops, it'll give it a bit of resistance, but then you can curl your fingers out to avoid catching the end of the card. So again, that is also, you know, it's really just a lot about timing, but eventually you'll get the hang of it, just to figure out right about how much you need to curl out so that the cards don't catch. Your index finger is gonna slowly move. Now, if you watch my index finger, it's gonna slowly move towards the thumb just so that the cards get the same angle when they drop, right? So the index finger moves closer to the thumb. These fingers curl out and the thumb just goes up the back. There's nothing too complicated about that. But you want the three things to kind of come together and you want to time it right so that the cards drop evenly one by one, and there's no cards catching anywhere. So some tips about that. I think having your thumb on the corner helps, because if I put my thumb on the side, it's harder for me to riffle up the side and have a consistent pointer release, because like my whole thumb's on it. But if it's on the corner, there's just a little bit of corner that's contacting my thumb, and that allows like there to be one point that the cards release from every time. Whereas if my thumb's here, it's not as consistent, it's a whole side. So corner works best for me. And with these three fingers, I like to line them up, but have my middle finger be the lowest one. So it's okay to do this and it's fine, but I find it a bit harder because I'd have to coordinate all three fingers to be exactly the same. And since, you know, these three fingers aren't the same length, I have my middle finger be slightly lower than the rest. So as the cards drop, they drop mainly from my middle finger, maybe a bit off my fourth finger. Right, but this would be kind of hard to do. So maybe that type of angling, right about there-ish. So if you watch it from the front, that's what it looks like. So once you've got that down, I'd recommend just practice doing that. And what you want to look for is, say about from this height, you want to look for the cards falling evenly, one by one, then slanting a little bit, and then landing. And you can practice that for a bit. It's also a great way to dribble cards. So in Magic and stuff, some things like the Bluff Pass, which looks like this, you know, you do this, you have them choose a card, King of Hearts, and you do whatever you do with it. That requires dribbling. So once you learn this, you can learn it as your main way to dribble cards, and it'll work for you that way. But once you've learned this, you'll get over to the second part, which is getting everything combined and put together. All right, so for this part, here's kind of how it goes. So here, I'm assuming you already know how to dribble the cards, right? So this should feel normal, just to take the cards and to dribble them down. So starting with the right hand, going to be dribbling, right? For right as you dribble, the left hand's gonna drop down and the right hand is going to go upwards to however high you want the Anaconda to be. And it's gonna stop moving right when you run out of cards, and you're going to bring your right hand back down with the last card, and it's gonna land on top of the packet with all the rest of the cards. So there are a few key things about this. So first off, you want to time it. So if you want your Anaconda to be higher, you're gonna have to move your right hand a bit faster to reach that point before you run out of cards. Or if you want to be lower, you can have your right hand movement be a bit slower. But the main concern here is the tilt, forward, backwards, left, right. So starting with left, right, you want it to be completely flat the whole way. Meaning if you watch it from the front side, the deck never really changes angles left, right. because if I tilt it this way, if you watch, the cards will kind of drop at a strange angle. And if I bring that up faster, the cards will kind of twist as they fall. The same as if I overcompensate and turn it this way, the cards will twist the other way. From this height, you can't tell as well, but if I bring it up higher, say if I do this, you can see the cards kind of tilt at a weird angle and make it really hard to catch. So as much as possible, you want to keep the deck level like this. And then from a front back perspective, you want to go up like this. Then as you go up, you want to tilt the deck slightly back. So you do this, then you bring it up slightly backwards like this. And so that'll create, I don't know how to describe it. There'll be a slight pressure against the other cards as they're going down. So it'll create this nice smooth thing. Otherwise, if you tilt it the other way, as the cards fall, they won't be connected. So you'll pretty much have a bunch of cards falling from the right hand to the left hand, but not in the nice line that there should be in an Anaconda. So if you master the timing, which is how fast you bring it up, the angling of left, right, keeping it flat, and the angling front, back of starting off like this, then moving back, you'll have pretty much the right hand part of it. And the only thing left about it is the only thing left is the left hand and, you know, how to catch and how the left hand moves. So for the left hand, right as you get started, the left hand's immediately gonna drop really quickly. So you're gonna start maybe about here, a bit above waist, so maybe here-ish. You're gonna start, and as you go, your left hand's gonna drop out as your right hand raises. Can I back up a bit? I'll bring the camera down a little bit. All right, your left hand's gonna drop, right, as your right hand goes up. So then it'll be here, then from about here on out, it's mostly right hand movement. So as you start, it's like that. Sorry for the bad catch. But the right hand will be moving up, but the left hand is just gonna drop. And you want the left hand to drop about at the same pace that the card's dropping. So if you see a card drop, they drop about that fast. So you want your left hand just to match that speed as it drops. Then have your, so it looks like it's expanding, but it'll follow the first card, first or second card down. Then it'll stop and the right hand will just keep dropping cards and raising up. So I know that's a lot of timing and stuff to fit in, but what I would say is just practice the move enough, and if you practice it a lot, all the stuff will kind of come together and it'll start to make more sense. So yeah, so that's pretty much the two things. Ask for how to catch the cards as they fall. Excuse me, gonna move this down a bit. Boom, okay. So how to catch the cards. So when you do a spring, you have this sort of hand thing. So the cards drop like that. Now the Anaconda is not too different, except you don't want your pinky sticking up right like that, because after you do this, your hand's gonna come down right on top of it and you don't want your pinky sticking straight up. So at first, when I first started doing the Anaconda, I would do it like this in like dealer's grip. But the only issue is cards would kind of slide back out this way. So to adjust for that, I'd have my hand here, so the cards would kind of hit me and would stay in one place. So it looked kind of like that, which is a little bit messy, and in terms of showmanship, might not be the best. So what I opted to do is to have my pinky kind of on the side like this. So as the cards fall, they'll clip the side of my pinky and land like that. But when my hand comes down, my pinky stays flat. So the cards pretty much fall and kind of hit the side. So they all stay in a general stack. And then when my hand comes down, the pinky doesn't get in the way. So it looks something like this. Now that's without left hand movement. Now I will admit, I'm not the best at catching them all in like a stack. Like I've seen other people do it. And they can just do a whole Anaconda, like a crazy big one, and catch it all like almost, you know, in a place where they can just grab it with their left hand. Now, I'm not amazing at catching them at the same time, but I'm decent enough that my cards don't look like a pancake most of the time. You guys probably saw a few times throughout this video where the cards landed and it's just this big platform of cards. But for the most part, that's what works for me. Just having it like this and having the cards kind of clip the pinky here. Now, in terms of what to look at when you're doing it, I look at my left hand. So I'm just trying to watch for where the cards are falling and moving my left hand accordingly. And the two things you don't want to do is you don't want the cards too forward. But if your hand is tilted slightly back, too forward isn't too big of an issue. You just want them to land right about there-ish. And that's good. And the cards will fall back and will hit your pinky, which is at an angle, which will stop them. But if your cards fall too far back and hit your pinky, then they'll bounce and they'll go forward. So you'll have the Anaconda, then as the cards fall, they'll hit the pinky and they'll shoot out forwards. And that makes a mess. So you want to land the cards right above where you want them to be. So if you want them to land right here, you want the cards to land right about there. Then the cards as they fall will slide back. So that means your left hand has to be tilted a little bit towards you when you do that. And then when you close up, it should be pretty nice and you can just go ahead and square the whole packet up. Okay, that was a lot of talking. I hope you guys got the point of the whole tutorial. I hope it was clear. Yeah, so I think the best thing to do is really just to start and try and be willing to practice over a surface where you can pick cards up, because cards always drop, especially with moves like this. So just try it out, and I'm sure you guys will figure out the timing. And I think, yeah, the best way to learn is really just by doing it and figuring it out. So allow yourself plenty of time to practice. Hope you guys enjoy the video. Be sure to check out my Instagram down below and some of my other videos. Subscribe if you want to, if you enjoy my content. Stay tuned. I gotta go film the B-roll. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. Oh yeah, almost forgot. We just got to 100 subscribers. Just want to thank you guys so much. It's a huge milestone for me. Before I started, YouTube subscribers and that whole number thing really didn't make much sense. But now that I've started, it's kind of crazy to think that, you know, there are people out there who actually, you know, really like watching my content. And it's great to think that, you know, people are learning from tutorials. I really just run this channel just for fun. It's kind of a hobby I have. I don't really like the word hobby, but for lack of a better word to describe it, I guess that's kind of what it is. So yeah, just wanted to say thanks, take a quick note of that. Yeah, you guys are amazing. Stay tuned, hope you guys enjoy this. I got some content, hopefully coming soon, maybe some tutorials and stuff. I'm still trying to figure out what exactly to do, but there will be videos. And I'm trying to get those out before school starts out. Once school starts up, my upload schedule will be a little more spaced out. So just FYI. Anyways, it's really cool. See you guys in the next video. Peace.